Let's talk about Amazon Kindle. I'm using this Kindle for almost more than 2.5 years, almost 3 years I will say, and still it's paying me off really big time. So in today's video we are going to do the Amazon Kindle review after almost 3 years. Make sure you watch this full video to understand you should buy Kindle, you should invest in Kindle or not, and what are your thoughts on the Kindle, what are my thoughts on the Kindle, why I love Kindle, why I hate Kindle. Everything I'm going to share in this video. So let's start from the basics, that Kindle review. So basically, if I talk about today, still Kindle is the one of the best investment I have did, I will say, because I have read more than 100 to 150 books on the Kindle. I have still have like more than 200 to 300 books on my Kindle device, which this, you know, this is all about around 16 GB all a Kindle, and 16 GB can contains more than thousands of books. But obviously I'm not sure I'm not going to read that much or not, but this Kindle device, at least 16 GB device, which contains at least currently 200 to 300 books, and I'm yet to read another 300-400 books, so I'm not sure how I'm going to do that. But talking about the Kindle review, it's robust, it's durable, easy to use, easy to carry, like the size is very small. I have already made many videos on the Kindle, like Kindle hacks, how to get free books on the Kindle, what are my thoughts on the Kindle, Kindle review, why you should buy Kindle. There are so many videos I already made. I will link the playlist here or here, or check out the link in the description where I will put all the Kindle videos, and after that you can decide should you buy Kindle or not. Now the second question that pops in mind, that to buy Kindle, you guys, like everyone have the paperback book, everyone can the paperback book, then why Kindle? If I want to give the one word or one sentence answer to this, then easy to use and you can read a lot of books, because reading is more important than having books, that I can say. But if I want to give the long answer about why Kindle, then it can be a really beautiful, or it can be in many different ways, depends on who you are, depends on what type of person you are. So my goal is always to read more books and understand from other people's experience, rather than having thousands of paperback books and not reading them, or just, you know, just buy the books and keep it into the bookstore. Because every time you will not be at the home, like for my job or for my current position, it's not like I'm always in the home. I travel, go on the treks, on the weekend I go somewhere else. So while traveling, it's hard to carry, you know, so many books. It's easy to carry a simple this much device, a plain small device, and you can carry at least 100 books in that, and you can read anytime you want. So that's the reason why Kindle. So if you, what are your whys, like why do you think that you should use Kindle? Let me know in the comment. Now the next question that I usually get, or next question that I want to answer, is how Kindle device become my favorite device. So it's not like that I hate paperback, or I hate paperback kind of books, or the hardcore books. I'm a diehard fan of hardcore books. I have a lot of hardcore books, and you know, I love reading. I love the smell of the book. I love everything about the paperback book. But my issue is all about, you know, I should read more, I should understand more, be aware more about the world, and that's how I started with the Kindle. So for almost 1 month I struggled with the Kindle, that yeah, how I'm going to read with the Kindle, how to, you know, this font, this black ink and everything, it will not be good for me, I cannot get the feeling of the book. But then I shifted my perspective from, you know, having book than reading book, and that changed everything. For the first 2 to 3 months you are going to struggle with the Kindle for sure, but once you get hands on it, then it becomes easy. Like if you are an Android person, and if you shift to the iOS or Apple device, then it takes a lot, little bit of time to, you know, understand all the functions, or understand how to use the Apple device. The same with any other function, when you shift into something new, it takes little bit of time to understand and, you know, adapt to that situation. So same with the Kindle, try, give it a try, and automatically it will also become your favorite, and you will start reading more books on Kindle rather than the paper. Now let's come to the point where we are going to talk about the pros of the Kindle. Why you should use Kindle, why, what are the pros of the Kindle. The first one, as I already told you, read anytime. You can carry this small device and you can read anytime. You can read in the morning, you can read in the night, you can read anywhere, you can read anytime. So that's the first read anywhere. read anytime. Second is read anywhere, which is another way. You can carry this anywhere while traveling, while going home, while going to the office. Just put this into the bag and you are done. You can carry these 100 books anywhere and you can read that. Third thing I love about the Kindle is the dark mode. Because in the dark mode, there are a lot of functions available. I mean, in the dark mode, when you, I love reading at the night, because usually at that time, I love reading fiction books. And because of the eyes and problem, you cannot keep the lights on. So it's better to use the dark mode on the Kindle and you can read whole night if you want to screw up your sleep just like me. So dark mode is something I love about the Kindle. And after that, Kindle plus audiobook. Like, you can sign Kindle device and the audiobook at the same time. While driving, I usually try to, you know, listen to the audiobooks. And after that, going home or after that, coming to the home, I try to read on the Kindle. So it automatically sign your data from Kindle to the audiobook. So whenever you are on the audiobook, it will automatically shift to this Kindle and the vice versa. That is something big thing about me, or that is something really enjoyable about the Kindle. Now let's talk about the cons of the Kindle. What are the cons? The first one is, as always, the smell of the book. You cannot get the smell of the book to the Kindle. It's like, it's highly impossible. But obviously, kuch paane ke liye kuch khona padta hai. So that is the kind of thing that you cannot get the feeling on the paperback device about the Kindle. But it's amazing to, you know, finish more books. So ultimately, mujhe kuch paane ke liye kuch khona pad gaya. Another drawback for me is, I buy paperbacks just to showcase in the video. Yeah, shit. This is one of the hard thing to do. But usually, you know, I have read this book on my Kindle. I have highlights also on in this Kindle. But I have brought this book, The Almanac of Nawal Ravikant, just to showcase in the YouTube video. That is the one of the hard thing for me. But I have to spend 2 times just to, you know, read one book. If I want to showcase on the YouTube video, I have to buy that again. Now let's talk about the battery life, which is the usually question that I get. So currently it's almost 3 years and I'm still not facing any issue with the battery life or any issue with the screen. I have like almost, it feels like new to me. Obviously after the update, it feels little bit slow, but it's not like that slow. But all the updates are good. New update is good. You can check out the new update wala video where I shared what is that new update. But to be honest, on the one charge, when I charge the one time, usually 1 week to 1.5 week, it automatically stays with me. So there is not a big issue when you charge 100%. It will, because you don't have anything, you just have the black screen. There are only contrast screens. So it usually lasts for around 1 week to 1.5 week. Depends on my reading speed, depends on how much time I read. But usually 1 week you can consider for sure. And the next question that I get is how to get free books on the Kindle. So I have already made one video on that. The link is in the description, or you can see or see here. I have already made one video on the Kindle, how to get free books on the Kindle. That is absolutely unique video. You can check out that video and wahapi you will get all the details. And you are looking for more and more Kindle hacks, then check out this video where I shared all the Kindle hacks that you need for the Kindle device. So that's pretty much everything about the Kindle pros, cons and Kindle review after almost 3 years of using, and it feels still good. If this device get harmed, then I will definitely buy another Kindle for sure, because Kindle is something I really really love, and Kindle is something I'm going to enjoy, or I'm going to keep that with me for lifetime. So make sure you buy Kindle, the link is in the description. And if you want to know more about the Kindle or the books, join our Telegram group or join the newsletter where you will get all the latest update. And if you are looking for more audiobooks, check out this video where I shared all the audiobooks about, you know, top 5 audiobooks or the Spotify audiobooks. And if you are looking for the Kindle playlist where I shared all the Kindle videos, then check out this video where I shared everything about the Kindle. So that's pretty much about today's video. See you in the next one.